Tingles with lullaby.
Hello, my tinglings. I thought today I'd do a little show and tell. These were given to me. I think they're from my grandma. My nieces brought them for me. They brought me some stuff from my aunt and some stuff. Some stuff for my grandma. So, I'm not 100% sure, but I'm pretty sure they come from my grandma. And so, I haven't actually looked through this bag, so I thought I might just show you guys as I look through that. But, these two pictures are of my grandma and grandpa. Obviously, I can get my hands on it. That's has like a bit of actually black in the hair, so it's a very salt and pepper gray that he has. It makes him not look that old, even though I'm not quite sure if he's turned 90 yet or if he's in his late 80s, but he's getting quite old. But he and my grandma still walk together every day, and you know, very, very good health. Which is, you know, that's just kind of a joke, because when our kids, and particularly when my parents would get together with my uncle Carrie, the joke about how, you know, parents just like to talk, that my grandparents just like to talk about their health ailments, but compared to what a lot of people go through, they are relatively minor, so it's always good. But yeah, they are in really good health, still move really well, and do a lot. My grandfather worked, I know he worked for the government, but I don't remember what exactly he did. He wanted to be a traveling salesman. And then after they got married, my grandma said she didn't want him to be gone all the time. So he had to find something else that he wanted to do. But he was always happy that he had retired whenever I saw him. And loves to read nonfiction books. So I remember him reading a book about Southwest that was called Peanuts, and, you know, telling us all about it and that sort of thing. So. And he also really, really enjoys the weather and knows really a lot about the weather statistics. So, for example, if he was watching the news and somebody said, oh, this was so-and-so record, he went down. This happened one time when I was at their house in the summer. He went down to the basement and he was checking out, his old records, because he was like, I don't think that's right. And he looked back and he wrote into the news station telling them that this was incorrect. So then they like sent him an apology and whatever, and like I think a gift certificate as well for helping them be correct, I guess. So he's a funny man, but yeah. So that's just a little story about him. I used to go out. So, I grew up in Maryland, but these grandparents lived in Utah, and then my mom's parents lived in Idaho. So, me and my sister used to go out for a month every year, and we'd usually spend about 3 weeks in Utah, most of our time with our grandparents, but sometime with our other family as well, and then usually be a week that was a family reunion. And then we'd go up and spend a week in Idaho as well. So, always got, even though we lived, you know, on the other side of the country, always got to still spend a lot of time with our family, and, you know, get to know everybody and, you know, keep those bonds there. So, So let's have a little bit of a look. This is the bird that I haven't seen. So my mom, maybe these are from my aunt, then I'm guessing. This was my cousin Lauren, and apparently this is Halloween, this last Halloween, where she was being Jesus for Halloween. There. Last time I was there, we were all playing Bananagrams. Thanks for watching this video.